could be a real sensation. And you just do not hit them better than that.
What a hit that is. That is incredible.
Big chance, here's a goal! Incredible scenes.
Now it is. Game on.
It's a wonderful finish. And what a huge goal that could be.
It's a brilliant finish.
Last Friday night, Dunfermline got off to an absolute flyer.
Incredible! 20 seconds on the clock! What a 6 minutes for Owen Moffat!
A brilliant win for the Pars, and tonight they host the league leaders.
Matthew Cajol with the coolest of finishes!
We're gearing up for another championship cracker as Dunfermline face Dundee United live from East End Park.
A very good evening. For the second week in a row, we are with Dunfermline Athletic, and a real test for the Pars tonight as they take on the league leaders and cinch championship favourites Dundee United here at East End Park. It's great to have you with us. It is the start of five consecutive home matches for Dunfermline Athletic. With us this evening, always at home in the crazy world of the championship, Leanne Crichton and James McFadden. A very good evening to you both. Leanne, if I can start with you, last weekend, obviously, fantastic victory for Dunfermline Athletic after what had been a poor run, three defeats, and they hadn't scored any goals in that time. Just what they needed, a win ahead of this huge test tonight.
Yeah, no, it was a great victory, a great first half performance in particular as well, and a lot of people that I've spoken to off the back of that game really enjoyed the Friday night game.
They've got a chance, they're at home, you know, we're looking at the pitch, it looks brilliant, and Dunfermline last week didn't look like a team that had forgotten how to win and forgotten how to score goals. They looked really good.
I think we're in for a really tasty encounter this evening here at East End Park. Let's have a look at the championship table as it stands this evening. And there you have it. Dundee United are unbeaten in the championship this season. They've won 8 matches and drawn 4 out of the 12. They have twice as many points as Dunfermline Athletic, who are on 14 and in the playoff places. As for the team lineups this evening, let's take a look at the side that the Pars will be hoping can challenge Dundee United tonight. And just 2 changes from the side that beat Greenock Morton last weekend, and they're both up front as Michael O'Halloran comes in, and in front of him, Craig Whiten leads the line for Dunfermline Athletic this evening. As for Dundee United, well, they've been on great form throughout this championship season, and they make just the 1 change this evening from the match where they drew 1-1 with Inverness County Thistle last weekend. Liam Grimshaw coming in and Kieran Freeman drops to the bench. Some familiar faces all around this evening, and one of them is between the sticks for Dunfermline Athletic. Denis Mehmet impressed at times last weekend against Greenock Morton. He is, of course, a former Dundee United player. He, along with his Dunfermline manager, James McPake, have been speaking to Brian McLauchlin.
In terms of reaching the top 4, possible promotion, is that something that's at the back of the players' minds at the moment?
Yeah, I think it's something that all teams would be looking for. You know, no one wants to go out and just finish somewhere in no man's land, really.
Let's hope for a fantastic evening of football. It usually is in the championship on a Friday night. Let's hand now to your commentary team of Michael Stewart, and it's a happy birthday to Alasdair Lamont.
Oh, thanks very much, Jonathan. There's absolutely nowhere I would rather be this evening in the company of some lovely people and Michael Stewart. A fascinating contest in prospect as the unbeaten league leaders visit East End Park, with their hosts keen to emphasise their own promotion credentials by stripping United of their invincible tag. Some moments of real poignancy ahead of this match, as will be observed around the country over this weekend, as the Dunfermline and Dundee United representatives leave the pitch. Dundee United, represented there by their director, Jimmy Fife. Dunfermline ended a 3-game losing run with a win at Morton, still make a couple of changes
as Craig Whiten and Michael O'Halloran come back in for McCann and Jakubiak. United's four-game winning run was halted last weekend, but just one change for them as Liam Grimshaw recovers from a bug to replace Kieran Freeman at fullback. So Chris Graham in charge of this one. As Jonathan mentioned pre-match, they've got a run of home games in which conceivably they could rack up a whole load of points and really put themselves in contention. But it's a tall order for them tonight against an informed Dundee United side, Michael.
Yeah, of course. I mean, look, nobody's been able to beat the Tannadice side this season. Dunfermline, obviously, as the guys were talking about before the game, the closest anyone has come.
And still well in this game going in at half-time at Easton Park with the scoreline. Dunfermline 0, Dundee United 1.
October's player of the month, still doing the business in November. Ty Fotheringham has made the difference. 1-0 to Dundee United at half-time. It is still all to play for here at East End Park. We do have a goal and it is very tight indeed. But it is always satisfying when we pick out a player at the start of the programme and he does the business during the programme. Leanne Crichton, Ty Fotheringham, he looks like a big talent coming through once again at Tannadice.
Yeah, he does, and he's been the difference in that half.
Ty Fotheringham has put the icing on the cake as far as Dundee United are concerned so far this evening. And speaking of icing on cakes, I do hope our commentator Alasdair Lamont will be getting some kind of cake because it is his birthday. And it's nice to see, Leanne, that Sammy the Tammy remembers commentators' birthdays.
It's excellent, isn't it? Alistair will be enjoying his moment of fame, I'm sure.
Brilliant cuddle, isn't it? I really enjoyed that cuddle. I don't know if that's the first cuddle he's had today for a while, but he really enjoyed it right in there.
I think Sammy's enjoying it as well, to be fair.
Oh, it's wonderful to see, and Alistair deserves it. Fantastic. Thank you, Sammy the Tammy. Wonderful scenes here at East End Park. I don't think you can beat that sort of content, but there is still plenty of good stuff out there from BBC Scotland. And plenty more good stuff coming from BBC Scotland tonight, in fact, as a view from the terrace. Hove's interview at 10:30 this evening after us on the BBC Scotland channel. Tomorrow, another packed day of football kicks off with Stewart and Tam off the ball midday on BBC Radio Scotland, followed promptly by Sports Sound on BBC Radio Scotland as they cover all the afternoon action. On the telly, the results will come in on BBC One Scotland at 4:30 with David Curry. And Tomo's here with the highlights tomorrow night at 7:30 on the BBC Scotland channel. And join me at 7:15 on Sunday as we wrap up the Premiership weekend. Let's carry on with the birthday celebrations this evening, because can you believe it? It's 100 years of Dundee United, and it has been a time of celebration for that football club, with plenty of the stars of that club getting together over the last month or so. And one of them has joined us here in the studio. Sean Dillon, welcome to Sportscene once again. Good to see you.
Yeah, thanks for having me. Great to see you.
2010 Scottish Cup winner with Dundee United, and it is a special time for Dundee United. Can you describe what's been going on?
Yeah, great celebration, obviously, of the club changing their name 100 years ago.
Well, Sean, thank you very much for joining us this evening.
Thanks for having me.
Leanne, James, we'll hear more from you at full-time as well. It is currently 1-0 to Dundee United here at East End Park. Time to hand back to your commentary team, Michael Stewart and Alistair Lamb.
Thanks again, Jonathan. Michael and I have just polished off those birthday cakes, so looking forward to a second half after a terrific first period in which Dunfermline threatened an opening goal, as did United in fairness. And it was the visitors who ultimately got it through Ty Fotheringham. 5 goals in his last 7 games for October's Player of the Month in the Championship, as we still await Dunfermline back onto the field of play. A fabulous game that has ended. Dunfermline 1, Dundee United 2.
Fantastic Friday night action. We have been joined, as if by magic, by the Dundee United manager, Jim Goodwin. Jim, congratulations on the victory. We saw the big grin on the pitch with the players and the staff come the final whistle there. How delighted are you with this victory this evening?
Yeah, I mean, look, we knew how important tonight's game was going to be. You know, Dunfermline gave us a really good game in the early part of the season. And
absolutely, Jim. Thank you very much for joining us this evening. A quick look at the Cinch Championship table as it stands this evening, and it makes very happy reading for those of a Dundee United persuasion. They are 32 points, a massive 8 points ahead of Raith Rovers, but of course they are in action this weekend. Dunfermline Athletic remain in the top four. And you know what? We're almost out of time. Not even a word in edgeways for Leanne Crichton and Jace McFadden,
always
but you'll be
best.
Happy about that.
Always the best.
From all of us on the Sportscene team, for now, good night.